this is the TLC series 4. So we went through the larva without weight, the larva with a beadhead weight, the principles of running the micro round, half round body glass material that's provided by hens throughout the world, the stretching material. Once we get to the pupal stage, we incorporate a little bit of thread, which starts taking away from the main TLC, threadless chironomid. But the series itself, still for the most part, the principles are the same. The next stage in the pupal is just at the emerging stage, near the surface. I have a tendency to run a lot of spider patterns. In the TLC, again, with the Clinkhammer BL550 hook design, has that natural comma shape or J shape to it that the insects have at this stage in their life. So again, we're going to start with the body material, as we have with all the other ones that we've tied previous to this series. We'll put a little bit of wax on the half round. We'll give it a start with a couple of quick turns at the eye of the hook. What we need to do is just come back just a tiny amount. We'll do a little room at the eye of the hook. Cut off the excess material. You can tie in the rib again, which we'll do here. And just bring it around. We'll and touching turns, try to untwist as you move forward or to the back of the hook. You can either cut off here the excess mylar that's not needed, and just progress down the body, keeping those wraps tight, stretching it out, keeping it thin. And then looser turns, loosening off the material, don't stretch it out as much. Moving forward, and as we move forward, we'll decrease the pressure to increase the ribbing size. Overall, and we'll half hitch off at the back of the thorax section. And now we'll move our ribbing forward. One full turn around at the base. And then just follow the ribbing up as you move up the hook shank with each consecutive turn of the mylar. Again, this will represent some of the gaseous segmentation, the gaseous pockets between the segments. And from here, you can just go second turn. Cut off your mylar. And go straight into a 3-knot whip finish, progressing forward again slightly. We don't want to build up too much material because we have extra material to add on. If you want to secure the body, this would be the time to do it, to add on the lacquered material. The lacquer onto your body. Keep it thin. It does not be built up heavy or thick or robust. So that was the pattern as we were tying before in the TLC series. Now I'm going to add a small thorax. Start that just behind the eye of the hook. And I'll use flosser we have, as we have done before.
So you get truck tomorrow?
Michael, I'm in the middle of video recording. Jeez. And we'll palm her in a hen hackle. I'll just pick one out of the cape here. It's just a Chinese hen. That looks to be about the right length. We'll clear the fluff off the back. And if you want it to be a full, fairly thick hackling, then just tied in so that you have hackles on both sides of the stem, or if you choose to, I have a tendency to tie them a little sparser, strip it all down the left-hand side of the feather with the shiny side facing you. I'll just do a little bit more here. And what we'll do is we'll tie this in. And up in front of the feather. And we'll cut off our tag end. And wrap the hackle forward. Each progressing wrap. You can actually follow the thread wrap slightly. Go over once over top. And once in front. And we'll do a three knot whip finish right here behind the eye of the hook. Pull it nice and tight. Either cut or pull away to the stem. I'll just cut it this time. And I'll cut the thread, keep your attention on it. And this would be the spider version of the pupa. Emergence. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.